What if it fails?
What happens if it fails is we not only haven't made progress, but I think we risk going backwards. And if you look here, I mean, here you have a city built on a rock, admittedly with a deep harbor, but no natural resources, and they have embraced trade. Today they have a per capita income of over $34,000 per person. It's because they have seen the benefits of engaging in global trade.
Yeah, but
this is what we need to do around the world to move developing countries into the developed country
status. Well, take a lead. Yesterday you came up with a package offering these four West African cotton producers tariff-free access.
That's what they asked for.
You don't need that because they don't sell into the U.S.
Well, that's because we have high tariffs and a quota. What we're saying, we're going to get rid of that altogether. They asked for market access. We've come forward with that. They've also asked for help on export subsidies. We're going to come through on that. They've also asked for help on domestic support. We're going to be able to do something on that. And they've asked for assistance and help. And frankly, that may in the end be the most important thing to the African farmer, because they are not productive or not efficient now. And the subsidies reduced alone will not make the difference. But we're willing to do it. We're willing to be helpful.
They want to see more progress on reducing the $4 billion you're plowing into your domestic cotton producers. Can't you answer their call?
We've got a proposal on the table to eliminate it altogether, as you know, and the only country to do so. So absolutely, we're working with them. They'd like it to have happened yesterday. It sometimes takes a little while to work these things through the system. This round will hopefully get done by the end of this year, then would be implemented after that. So we've got a good discussion with them. I think we'll be able to come up with a resolution for these four countries. But the bigger issue is, how do you be sure that all of the African countries and the developing world in general have access to markets for their products? And their best product right now is agriculture. That's the product where they can be most competitive. Getting rid of the subsidies is part of it, but if they don't have access by reducing tariffs and quotas, they will not be able to be successful.
Okay, quota-free, duty-free. That's what we're talking about. How close are you to an agreement here in principle?
I think we'll get an agreement more than just in principle, in fact. I think that could be another great benefit of this round. The U.S. is already very open to these countries. We can be even more open, and we're willing to do that. But the key is, again, not just for the least developed countries and for specific products, but overall there needs to be market access between countries. For instance, these developing countries we're talking about pay 70% of their tariffs to other developing countries. They need to reduce their barriers to each other so that south-to-south trade can result in the kind of prosperity we're seeing behind us.
But the U.S. has a role to play here. Of course, there's caveats. Yesterday you said, okay, we're fine with the quota-free, duty-free, except for Bangladesh, except for textiles out of Cambodia. Why don't you just step up to the plate and give these people what they want?
We are giving them what they want right now, which is $2.5 billion worth of textile exports to the United States last year from Bangladesh alone, 20% increase. That will continue to happen. In fact, we'll give them even more access by being able to give them total tax-free, duty-free access for some of those textiles. The only thing I raised yesterday was, can we provide for all of that to be duty-free? What will the impact be on our other partners, particularly in Africa, who we've provided the same access to? A lot of textiles come in the United States already duty-free from the least developed countries. But where a country is globally competitive and doing very well in our market, the question is, should they get that kind of access to the detriment of others? And what is the impact on the domestic industry there? So these are issues we're working through, but the United States is already the most open. We'll continue to be open, and we'll do more and commit to it this week. That's another thing we can get done.